Good morning to you. I'm happy to see you. Good morning. There it is, guys. Good morning song. I didn't do it. I don't think I did it once last week because, man, there is dissension in the world of the good morning song. I mean, people are split. Like, when the revolution comes and it's time for everybody to take sides, the world will split between those who love the good morning song and those who hate it. My mother will be leading those who hate it revolution. And toss up who would lead the, you know, I've got to tell you, I, at this point, I don't even know if I like it anymore. I did think I do, but you guys have me all in a tizzy, but I did it for you anyways. Hi everyone, so, who watched the Video Music Awards last night? Look, it's just not, they just aren't as good as they used to be, you know? But last night was definitely an improvement over last year. Last year, that Vegas debacle. Britney opened the show. God bless her, she read that thing so fast. But she looked amazing. Like, she looked like old Britney. And she seemed good. Like, she just seems a little lobotomized is what worries me. Like, it's just a little bit, like, now it's like, okay, I am a robot, and I will be good, and I will sit here and be good, and be, thank you, God, thank you, family, thank you, my kids, thank you, my fans. It's a little like, okay, so now now to combat your crazy, you've now lost all, anything interesting about it, you know? I don't know, I want something in between. Like, I like crazy Britney a little bit, but I don't like, I'm afraid she's gonna die, Britney, you know? I liked pre-crazy Britney when it was just, like, crazy Britney, you know, like, Me Against the Music Britney. Like, that's the Britney I really, really love, you know? So, we'll see what happens, I don't know. For me, standouts were Pink. I mean, I think Pink's amazing. I love her new song, I love her new video, and I love what she did on the VMAs. I loved the Paramount Backlot thing, I thought that was so cool for the show. So cool. And I like that they make it three-dimensional. Even though the Vegas thing didn't work last year, I like that they tried to do it again this year, and it worked much better this year. Them going out on the lot. Pink, amazing. Like, I just think she's amazing. And the Jonas Brothers, I'm sorry, that was a fantastic performance. I mean, production value-wise. That was really cool, I thought. And I think they looked adorable. Russell Brand, I thought, was kind of funny. I didn't think, Nina and Matt liked him a lot. I didn't think he was as funny as Nina and Matt did, but I liked him. He was funny. He was good. I like him. I like Russell Brand. I think he's cool. But overall, I wasn't like blown away by him, but I didn't dislike him. And Rihanna looked gorgeous, amazing. She does have some big thighs, doesn't she? Those are some big legs. Big leg Rihanna. I have a serious crush on Chris Brown. And Christina Aguilera, that genie in a bottle thing was kind of cool, but then it got weird. Like, then it got, like, boring Christina Aguilera. But if the start with the genie, I didn't even recognize genie in the bottle at the beginning. I was like, what is she singing? And then I was like, oh my God, it's a genie in a bottle. You gotta rub me the right way, Christina. Oh my goodness. So VMAs, overall, Pink was the big standout to me. I'm obsessed with that song. Chances are I'm opening with it. Of the day. Some sad stuff over on New York City. Rent closed on Broadway yesterday. And I knew, you know, it wasn't like it was an unexpected closing. Like, it was supposed to close during the summer and then they extended and, it closed and I guess I was kind of like, eh, whatever, Rent's closing, like, it's about time. It was kind of my first feeling. When I was thinking about it, like, it's crazy that it's closed because Rent, like, it's just bizarre, because Rent opened in 1996, right? I was 15, I was a sophomore in high school. And, you know, all of us that went to school together were all theater kids, and we all went, like, Rent crazy. Like, Rent was, like, all we cared about. Like, we knew every lyric, and it was, like, me and Julie and Josie and Sarah and Jason. Jason wouldn't get into Rent because we all did, and whatever. But we all went, like, crazy for it. And it was just so bizarre. Like, I remember, like, my mom at one point, like, didn't want me listening to it because she thought it was, like, nasty. Now, first of all, she wouldn't care. And it just, like, it wasn't that long ago, but it was so long ago. And, like, it's just so part of my life. Now, I'm not even, like, I wouldn't consider myself a huge Rent fan anymore. Like, it's, like, I still know every lyric, and I know every, you know, but, like, I was a young teenager, like, struggling with my sexuality and dealing with, like, it's just so bizarre, the evolution, like, for it to now be closed, and to think that as I've gone through all of those changes in my life, every moment since I was 15 years old, that show has been running 8 performances a week in the same theater. That can, like, trip me out. Like, that show, no matter what, is 8 performances a week in New York City. And that show has stayed there to inspire different people in a different way as I've gotten older and gotten, you know, moved on and done other things in my life. And when I lived in New York, I went back and saw the show every once in a while. And, like, always, you know, like, the you know, like, I loved to go in and see, like, different movies and stuff. I would like different movies. There's always more things, or more Marines, but I always like but what I think is kind of cool is they recorded the final performance, right? They recorded it and one other performance, and they're splicing it together, and they're doing this thing. I forget the company. I'll get the information when it's getting closer. This company is now doing this one weekend release of Rent, the final performance, videotaped in movie theaters, and I think it costs like $20 or something. And so it's like bringing live entertainment to movie theaters across the country, which I think is so cool. And, like, whether or not you're the hugest Rent fan, I think you should go support it, because I think the more support it gets, the more events like that will happen. And I just think that's very cool. And as opposed to, like, waiting for a movie version or going to see the movie version of Rent, which, you know what I mean? Like, it's something, like, for people who can't get to New York to see the final performance of Rent, like, at least they can get a little piece of it. It's not quite the same, but, like, they can see what happened that day. Like, I just think that's cool. So I want everyone to go support that. Anyways, I love you all. That's my thoughts on today. Sorry, Rent. Goodbye. It's weird. It's a little bit of a weird thing for me. I don't know why. Home is sentimental. That's just me. Love.